We're receiving reports now of another building collapsing.
That's right, Jeremy. A third building has collapsed. We had the collapse of the two main towers about an hour after the actual explosion, which was about 9:15 in the morning. If you wanted to calculate a time to cause maximum disruption, you would calculate that time as the start of the working day and perhaps the biggest, busiest complex in the world. There were those two explosions. I was at the base of one of those buildings and it literally shook.
Saw the big hubbub going on around Building 7. Walked around it. I saw a hole. I didn't see a hole bad enough to knock a building down, though. So, there was definitely fire in the building, you know, but I didn't hear any, you know, I mean, maybe this is movie crap. I didn't hear any creaking or I didn't hear any indication that it was going to come down. And all of a sudden, the radios exploded and everybody started screaming, get away, get away, get away from it. And I was like a deer in the headlights and I look up and I think I remember pretty clearly the two guys that I knew were on the transit radio. I don't know if those tapes are out there, but I can try and look for them and show you exactly what I'm talking about. But it was that moment, you know, get away. And I looked up and it was nothing I would ever imagine seeing in my life. You know, the thing started peeling in on itself. And I mean, there was an umbrella of crap 7 feet over my head that I just stared at. And somebody grabbed my shoulder and I started running and the shit's hitting the ground behind me. And the whole time you're hearing thoom, 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 thoom. So I think I know an explosion when I hear it, you know? I was real close to Building 7 when it fell down. And running away from that sucked. That's one of the things that I live with all the time. And I don't know, but that didn't sound like just a building falling down to me while I was running away from it. There's a lot of eyewitness testimony down there hearing explosions. I didn't see any reason for that building to fall down the way it did. And a lot of guys should be saying the same thing.
Jane, what more can you tell us about the Salomon Brothers building and its collapse?
Well, only really what you already know. Details are very, very sketchy. There's almost a sense downtown in New York behind me, down by the World Trade Centers, of just an area completely closed off as the rescue workers try to do their job. But this isn't the first building that has suffered as a result. We know that part of the Marriott Hotel next to the World Trade Center also collapsed as a result of this huge amount of falling debris from 110 floors of the two twin towers of the World Trade Center. As you can see behind me, the Trade Center appears to be still burning. We see these huge clouds of smoke and ash, and we know that behind that there's an empty piece of what was a very familiar New York skyline, a symbol of the financial prosperity of this city. But people don't really know what to say or what to think. I think they feel the bubble of their security as being in America has definitely been popped. This city and this country will not be the same. But they don't really know where to turn. That's the very sad thing. I think there's going to be a lot of very, very traumatized people that has hit them very, very hard.
Jane, I think many of us, when we heard the news, perhaps on the radio earlier today, were completely flabbergasted by it and just couldn't comprehend it. I mean, it almost sounded too far-fetched. I was wondering what it's felt like for you being in Manhattan. Well, unfortunately, I think we've lost the line with Jane Stanley in Manhattan. Perhaps we can rejoin her and follow that up later.
Now, here we're going to show you a videotape of the collapse itself.
Describe that.
Now we go to videotape the collapse of this building.
It's amazing.
Amazing, incredible, pick your word. For the third time today, it's reminiscent of those pictures we've all seen too much on television before, when a building was deliberately destroyed by well-placed dynamite to knock it down.
I can't attest to the validity of that. All I can attest to is that by noon or 1 o'clock, they told us we had to move from that triage site up to Pace University, a little further away, because Building 7 was going to come down or being brought down.
Did they actually use the word brought down, and who was it that was telling you this?
The fire department, and they did use the word, we're going to have to bring it down. And
standing there, we were watching the building, actually, because it was on fire, the bottom floors of the building were on fire, and, we heard this sound that sounded like a clap of thunder. Turned around, we were shocked to see that the building was... it looked like there was a shockwave ripping through the building, and the windows all busted out, and, it was horrifying. And then, about a second later, the bottom floor caved out, and the building followed after that, and we saw the building crash down all the way to the ground. We were in shock, and then the worst part about it, we saw the smoke and the plumes of smoke coming after us.
But even then, they said, hey, you got to stay behind this line because they're thinking about taking this building down. They're not sure if it's stable or not. So they were holding a line off because they had knowledge that something was going to happen. Well, they pushed us back a little bit. About 15 minutes later, a couple minutes later, they started calming down. They let the border through. People started coming back out into the street. We watched like 5 New York City buses jam-packed with people wanting to do search and rescue, head down there towards Building 7. People walked out into the middle of the street to see these people off, like Bon Voyage. And right then, Building 7 came down, and it was a stampede.
Guys, we are walking back. There's a building